respect, Senate.
Come back here with me. No one stop that thing.
Just a moment.
You there? Are you the muse to answer my call? The pleadings of a poet with the honor of France in his heart? Say the name Jacques-Louis David and see if you don't gag on the sound. Well, I have written a series of poems satirizing the life of that most despicable propagandist. Sadly, the final verses are under lock and key in my abode. If you could retrieve them, the people of France would learn the truth about David and his confabulations, and my legacy would be assured. Go.
Faut l'envoyer à Bicêtre. Colourful metaphors, trenchant hyperbole, that sort of thing. All the sort of rubbish the overeducated adore. As good as any other given reason these days.
Oh well, got better things to do anyway.
in verse. Bravo, mon ami, bravo! Now all of France may hear the conclusion of Le Jeu de Paume and see the true hues that color Jacques-Louis David. Oh, they'll lose their heads with laughter, I guarantee.
Small favor. This is damned awful. But I promised Bonaparte, damn him. Seems a lady has caught his eye. What the deuce is her name? Juliette? Josephine. He wants to take a romantic stroll, but the royalists are after. Bonaparte is to meet her just south of the Palais Bourbon. I need you to clear out any royalists in their path.
Bienvenue dans mon échoppe.
What is your rank?
I'll fight you.
Captain. Captain, for now.
Move your ass. You
I
heard me.
Have prospects, though.
I'm sure.
Shut
Very
up.
Good prospects.
As true as your toe, well, not your left ear and your right.
It's a lovely day for a walk.
Yes, of course. Shall we?
You want to fight?
Knock you sideways.
I'll fight you.
Keep your distance.
Move
Stand
away
here.
Or I'll crack your skull.
Move away.
Talking to you, you sod.
your bloody legs off!
Halt!
Citizen!
This has been... You...
Yes, it has, hasn't it?
It's just that you're... Those large, luminous... Those...
Eyes?
Yes. They are bewitching. I can barely breathe, talk, think. We must meet again.
Oh, yes, perhaps. Well, ta-ta.
I think that went pretty well.
Yeah.
Johannes.
What's happening? Tentative et charité bien ordonnée commence par soi-même.
Mais pourquoi tant de fragile?
Maintenant, on arrive donc.
Journals ridicule me no end. They call the new machine a whirligig. Imagine, I devise a humane method of execution and the newspapers do nothing but print negative reports. Could you print this article, emphasizing the advantages of the guillotine, then surreptitiously replace the journals sold on the street with the new ones?
But my dear doctor, do you not agree that the purpose of an execution is to show the people the terrible retribution of the state?
The purpose of an execution is simply to end the life of a criminal. My machine accomplishes this in the best way.
I disagree, citizen. We want to see the man drawn and quartered. We want to see his head fly from his neck, not plop into a basket.
We all know stories of executions gone awry, ears lopped off and so forth. No, we must have a better way, and thanks to science, that way is at hand. With this machine, built by Tobias Schmidt, I can cut off your head in the twinkling of an eye, and you never feel it.
Vous seriez surpris.
At last, my new apprentice. Hurry, we need the new edition printed right away.
Let's go.
grind of death. New machine would remove all spectacle from public execution.
Faut l'envoyer à Bicêtre.
Pourquoi ce revirement soudain?
National disgrace! National disgrace.
Greetings.
New machine would remove all spectacle from public execution. New machine would remove all spectacle from public execution.
My friend.
By your turn, lad.
Goodbye, later. Watch your
Good morning, sir. Decent profits.
She was a favorite of that citizen de Sa that came around so much. He never treated her proper. I told her, send him away, but he pays so much. Look! Ropes! Whip! That's the sad, all right, Randy bastard. Poor Susanna! She was a favorite of that citizen de Sade.
Oh, God, there's men coming
so
and going all the time. I didn't see de Sade last night, but he could have been here.
Away.
Comes here a lot. It was too dark for me to see him proper. But there were some odd goings on last night. One John came in but didn't stay long enough to really do anything. And then there were two men, but only one went into Susanna's room.
That whip? Well, I suppose it could belong to Dusad. I sell him all sorts of things. But you know, there's a student, strange fella. He wanted to buy all the same things that Dusad bought. Seemed to think Dusad is some kind of god or something. I've got his address in the delivery book. Let me see. Yes! Here it is.
Dusad told me about her. I arranged a time and thought about all the things I would do to her. I started to lose my nerve, though, so I drank a couple of bottles of wine. By the time I got there, I couldn't go through with it. I turned around and left.
Anything else?
I heard two men in the dark just when I was leaving. One of them said, "After it's done, come and meet me in the church courtyard at Saint Nicolas des Champs. I'll pay you there."
I'm able to say what the Marquis was engaged in last night. It was a rare...
Unhand my master!
That took change.
You, shut up!
It's all too delightful. Really, murder a girl? Those days are behind me. But I do enjoy the farce. I did visit Susanna with some frequency, but not last night. I'm sure my valet can confirm my whereabouts. There was a young man, Some days ago, perhaps rather too taken with my philosophies, I recommended Susanna to him. It's not impossible he might know something. It's quite all right, Olivier. This may be amusing.
All the time. I've got nowhere to go. Who are you looking for? I saw a couple of fellas meet here late last night. One of them was dressed all fancy. Must be a servant. I overheard him mention his master, the Marquis. Afterwards, the other man went into that building right there.
You were cheering.
Maintenant, demi-tour et repartez d'où vous venez.
I'm unable to say what the Marquis was engaged in last night. It was a rare night off for me. If any of his personal effects are missing, well, he gets caught up in his activities and becomes After the degradations that I've suffered at the Desaad's hands, I jumped at the chance to put a gruesome end to the man. I do hope you're proud of yourself. That animal Desaad should be in here instead of me.
A Jezebel killed. Hardly a crime in my estimation. Take your due. Me.
les marchandises.
Arnold, what cheer?
Mais pourquoi fait-il? Hey.
No end to it. We managed to recover the stolen crown jewels. Now we find three prominent gems are still missing. And one of those is the French blue itself. The jeweler Lefrancois has a shop near Allograin. It's possible the thieves tried to sell the gems to him.
Well, this is a surprise.
Pleasure to meet you, Monsieur.
Ah! Ah! I'll get you right in!
As a matter of fact, there was a man who came in here with an impressive diamond. I refused to have anything to do with it. And ever since, he's been lurking in an alley nearby and badgering my customers.
I didn't take anything!
I'm not bringing that.
Diamonds. I will see that they are safely returned to the National Convention.
Du doute parmi les citoyens.